And here we are, ladies and gentlemen, welcome finally again at the flat in Greenwich Village, New York City, for episode number 107. We are getting up there. Ladies and gentlemen, with great pleasure, I would like to introduce my wonderful colleagues and friends tonight. They're one of a kind. I would like to start from this young man. He has been already here a couple of times, and each time I like him more and more, and this is Paul Sikivi. Hey man,
hey,
how are you?
Good to be back.
Good to see you. And on drums we have another friend that has been here a few times before, I believe three times before, and I should say he's just the legendary Dennis McCrell, right there. Good to have you here, both of you guys.
Thank you. Good to be here.
All right, so, you know, I put together an interesting program tonight. I hope we can manage to go through all of it because it's quite a few tunes. But I have to tell you a secret right away that in the oven there is a lasagna baking, you know. That's an important side of the story, and of course many of you know that when we finish the live stream, very often there is a little party going on, so the lasagna will be the main chapter of the party, hopefully. Anyway, back to the music. Okay, I'm gonna fix this right there. So we would like to start with a Cole Porter classic entitled You're the Top.
Thank you.
Top by Cole Porter, Paul Sikivi, and Dennis McCrell right there. All right, you know, the next tune is something that means quite a lot to me for two reasons. First, because the first time I heard Dennis McCrell live many years ago, I've said that before, was in Milan back in 2004, if I remember right, when Dennis came to play the Blue Note in Milan with Hank Jones. That's right. And you know, the audience was made just by musicians. I mean, the full room of musicians, because we couldn't wait to hear, of course, the great maestro Hank Jones that we all love, still love so much. And then was playing drums, and George Mraz was on bass. And among the many beautiful tunes that they played that week, because they had the residency at the Blue Note for about a week, there is this one song by Ted Jones that is called Lady Luck. The second reason is that, because this tune is one of my favorite of my nephew in Los Angeles, the young Elijah, 16 years old. And he loves jazz, and he loves this song. So we dedicated this to Elijah, my nephew. All right. Pretty good. Would you like to give us 4 bars, Dennis?
If you insist.
I'd love to.
Thank you.
by Ted Jones, Lady Luck, that was the title. All right, so the next one is a Jerome Kern, a beautiful song entitled The Last Time I Saw Paris. And the tune, I say this for my friends piano players out there, probably you know this already, but if you don't, check it out, because there is a fantastic Bud Powell solo recording of this tune, where actually Bud Powell gives glimpses of wonderful stride on that song. So check it out, because it's remarkable. But of course, now we're going to offer you our own rendition.
Thank you.
and that was the one and only Dennis McCrell that makes the drum set sing.
That's right.
Yeah, it's an art of in his own to be able to play drums so melodically, and he's the best. I love you, man. Beautiful.
Thank you.
All right, so we are going to continue with another wonderful jazz classic, and this is a tune that I've been wanting to study for years, and finally I got to put my hands on it. This is Ruby My Dear by Thelonious Monk.
Thank you.
that was Ruby, my dear. Ruby, my dear. Of course, I should have mentioned that beside the composer, Monk, I should mention some of the greatest interpreters of this wonderful tune. My mentor, Barry Harris, that really he felt it so much. And of course, you can find the different recordings, even videos of Barry playing it. And every time, doing something different with that tune. Amazing. The Art of Jazz Improvisation. And Hank Jones, of course, that I mentioned before, among many others. All right, so let's continue with something. We switch the gears a little bit now. does well, Richard Rodgers. Gentlemen, well, it's like driving a Rolls Royce.
With an expert driver, yeah.
I love it, I love it. All right, so at this point, we are opening a little chapter that I do, something that I do seldom, is to play my own original tunes. And I've got three of them. The first one is entitled Veronica, dedicated to my dear friend Veronica here in New York. And we saw actually each other last week in Italy briefly, because I had to fly over to play a little gig for Veronica's father, that is another friend of mine, Nicola, and I love them both. All right, so here's the tune for Veronica.
Thank you.
That's Veronica for my dear friend. The next original one is brand new because actually I composed this last week while I was in Italy. You know, it's like you are strolling around and suddenly a melody comes to you, and then as soon as you get back to the hotel, you try to write it down on a piece of paper. So this is the piece. I think might be reminiscent of a little bit of Harold Gardner and George Shearing here and there, but that's the way it is. I hope you enjoy it. It doesn't have a title yet, and so on the chart that I gave to Paul, I just wrote new tune, so that could be even a title probably. And by the way, this was dedicated to Nicola, my friend Nicola. All right. Thank you. that was the new tune. The new tune.
Wonderful, gentlemen.
All right, so I think we have to cut one tune that was another original. So you've heard enough originals tonight, I guess. But what I would like to play for you before the last number is this song that I was introduced to this tune actually again last week while in Italy by my dear friend Antonio Izzi. Antonio, I don't know if you're watching, but I send you my regards and thank you so much for showing me this wonderful track that was originally recorded by George Shearing. And this is a title that I never heard before, but this most beautiful melody. It's called Miss Invisible. You can find the Shearing recording very easily on YouTube if you just punch in George Shearing Miss Invisible. By the way, I found out that there is a Taylor Swift song by the same title that these days is very, very famous, but it's got nothing to do with this one. So you should definitely check it out. And I'm gonna play it for you. I try to make my own transcription from the George Shearing record of this. Miss Invisible. And once again, thank you, Antonio, for introducing me to this wonderful piece of music. Miss Invisible.
Yeah. Isn't it beautiful?
It's really, really beautiful. So, thank you very much. I'll spend the next probably 10 years practicing this piece of music before I get it right, but it was probably an okay approximation of the idea. So, by the way, if you actually know this, if any of you out there, the virtual audience, know anything about this melody, please let us know in the comment. I'm very, very curious. I made the research online, I couldn't find really anything. So, okay. So we got one more for you. I would like to, first of all, to thank my wonderful colleagues that are still willing to do the effort to come here at the flat to play with me. I'm very, very grateful because they make, I said this before, I'm not scared of repeating myself, they make this place my favorite jazz club in the world, you know, so that's very important. I would like to thank all the audience that has been following us for so many episodes, and I'm not ashamed to remind you that we could go on for so long thanks to your generosity and support and love and affection. So we are grateful for all of that. One more tune that I'm not going to announce the melody because it comes a little bit as a surprise in the arrangement, but I have to give credit to the idea of this arrangement that is our great friend and one of the greatest pianists around, actually ever, one of the greatest ever, that is Monty Alexander. I kind of got inspired from his own arrangement for this tune. All right, so here we are. it. Isn't she lovely? Thank you so much, ladies and gentlemen. We love you, and we'll be back here next Tuesday. We'll let you know all about it. Once again, the one and only Dennis McCrell on drums, and the wonderful, incredible Paul Sikivi on bass. Rossano Sportiello, ciao!